हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू टू सक्सेस सीडीज एजुकेशन। यहाँ पर मैं आपके लिए लाई हूँ करंट अफेयर्स मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस फॉर्मेट में फॉर द मंथ ऑफ नवंबर 2016। दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो। वील स्टार्ट फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन 46। क्वेश्चन नंबर 46 देखते हैं। वेयर इन द वर्ल्ड हैज द वर्स्ट कोरल डाई ऑफ बीन रिकॉर्डेड। वी ऑल नो व्हाट आर कोरल्स। ये डीप सी में कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट के डिपॉजिट से फॉर्म होते हैं। दीज आर द फोर ऑप्शंस एंड द करेक्ट आंसर इज द ग्रेट बैरियर रीफ विच इज सिचुएटेड इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया। इसकी कुछ और इंफॉर्मेशन देखते हैं। The worst mass coral bleaching event has happened on Australia's Great Barrier Reef. It has killed more corals than ever before. Nearly two-thirds of the 2,300 kilometer long reef or 700 kilometer stretch of coral in the Great Barrier Reef's northern part have died in the past 9 months. Coral reefs are result from the natural work of little polyps which are budded on top of one another. They are the most biologically diverse ecosystem of the planet. Over the centuries, the shells, which are mostly made up of calcium carbonate of these corals, combine to form the exotic shapes of coral reefs. Coral bleaching causes corals to expel tiny photosynthetic algae, draining them of their color. So, ये जो आप देख सकते हैं, brightly colored corals हैं, इनका कलर ब्लीच हो चुका है, यानी कि नाउ दे आर टर्न्ड व्हाइट। इट कैल्सिफाइज द कोरल्स टू टर्न देम इनटू व्हाइट। व्हेन अ कोरल ब्लीचेस इट इज नॉट डेड, दे कैन रिकवर इफ द वाटर टेम्परेचर ड्रॉप्स एंड द एल्गे आर एबल टू रिकॉलोनाइज देमसेल्व्स। द रीजन फॉर दिस कोरल ब्लीचिंग इज इट अकर्स व्हेन एबनॉर्मल एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस सच एज वार्मर सी टेम्परेचर्स आर देयर। तो ये जो कॉज है कोरल ब्लीचिंग का, ये है राइज इन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वॉटर ऑफ द सी। दैट इज वाई दीज कोरल्स आर ग्रेजुअली डाइंग। लेट अस सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 47। वेयर इज एशियाज फर्स्ट साइकिल हाईवे। एशिया का फर्स्ट साइकिल हाईवे, डेडिकेटेड हाईवे फॉर साइकिल्स, ये कहां पर सिचुएटेड है। इन ऑप्शंस में से करेक्ट आंसर है उत्तर प्रदेश, इंडिया। Asia's first and longest cycle highway was inaugurated in Uttar Pradesh. It is India's first cycle highway. It is 207 kilometer long. It runs between the towns of Etawah and Agra. The cycle highway has been constructed by the UP Public Works Department. ये जो cycle highway है, ये main highway के parallel चलेगा। It is about 7 feet wide and is separated by a divider from the main highway, which ensures the safety of cyclists. ये जो track है, ये शुरू होता है इटावा में, बहुत famous lion safari है वहां से, और अपने रास्ते में इसके 92 villages आते हैं across two districts. It crisscrosses the natural beauty of the Chambal and Yamuna rivers. And on its way, कुछ important tourist destinations हैं like नगावे का किला, राजा भोज की हवेली and बतेश्वरनाथ temple. Question number 48. Name the newly appointed Director General of Military Operations. In options में से correct answer है option B, Lieutenant General A.K. Bhatt. The Appointments Committee of Cabinet, that is ACC, has appointed Lieutenant General A.K. Bhatt as the new Director General of Military Operations. Inke predecessor the Lieutenant General Ranbir Singh. Lieutenant General A.K. Bhatt will be in charge of all army operations, including on the LOC, that is the line of control, which has seen heightened tension. He belongs to the Gorkha Rifle. Question number 49 hai, as per the new taxation laws amendment bill passed recently, which anti-poverty scheme of the government of India will get investments? In options, basic correct answer hai option A, प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण योजना 2016। इसकी कुछ और इन्फॉर्मेशन देखते हैं। द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द टैक्सेशन लॉज सेकेंड अमेंडमेंट बिल 2016। इस अमेंडमेंट के अकॉर्डिंगली इट इज मैंडेटरी फॉर ब्लैक मनी डिक्लेरेंस, जो लोग ब्लैक मनी डिक्लेयर करेंगे उनको 25% ऑफ द अमाउंट विच इज डिक्लेयर्ड प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण योजना में डिपॉजिट करना होगा फॉर अ 4-year लॉक इन पीरियड विदाउट इंटरेस्ट। दोज हु चूज टू डिक्लेयर देयर इल गॉटन वेल्थ स्टैश्ड टिल नाउ इन बैंड 1,500 रुपीज करेंसी नोट्स अंडर दिस स्कीम विल हैव टू पे अ टैक्स एट द रेट ऑफ 30% ऑफ द अनडिस्क्लोज्ड इनकम। ऑल्सो 10% पेनल्टी विल बी levied on the undisclosed income and there will be a Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan cess at the rate of 33% of the tax. The money from this will be used for projects of irrigation, infrastructure, primary education, primary health, housing, toilets and livelihood so that there is justice and equality. Question number 50. We have to name India's first digital village. और इन चार options में से correct answer है option C, Akodra, Gujarat. Akodra village in Sabarkantha district of Gujarat has earned the coveted tag of becoming India's first digital village. ये जो गांव है इसकी population 1,191 है और इसमें 250 हाउसहोल्ड्स हैं जो एक कैशलेस सिस्टम के हिसाब से अपनी गुड्स और सर्विसेज की पेमेंट करते हैं। ऑल द ट्रांजैक्शंस इन द विलेज आर कैरिड आउट थ्रू डिजिटल मॉडल्स लाइक एसएमएस, नेट बैंकिंग और डेबिट कार्ड्स। द विलेज वाज अडॉप्टेड बाय द आईसीआईसीआई बैंक अंडर इट्स डिजिटल विलेज प्रोजेक्ट इन द ईयर 2015 और इस विलेज को कैशलेस बना दिया गया है बाय अडॉप्टिंग डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी। The villagers' most important transactions like selling agricultural produce at the local market or selling milk at the cooperative society has been made cashless. It has primary, secondary and higher secondary schools equipped with smart boards, computers and tablets. It can be said that this village has become prime example of how e-banking can be practically implemented in Indian villages without much difficulty to make India cashless economy. Question number 51. We have to name the film that has won the coveted Golden Peacock Award at the 47th International Film Festival of India. The venue for this film festival was Goa. Out of these four options, the correct answer is option A, Daughter. Iranian film Daughter has won the coveted Golden Peacock Award at the 47th IFFI. It has been directed by Reza Mirkarimi. It is a family drama set in southern Iran. It brings out intergenerational conflict between a strict father and a young daughter. Let us see question number 52. Which of these states' chief minister is not a member of the CM's committee on demonetization? Government of India ne committee form ki hai, the CM's committee on demonetization. In mein se kis state ka chief minister is committee ka member nahi hai aur iska answer hai option C, Punjab. The Union Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has called up Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar. Students, this is the state of Bihar. Karnataka Chief Minister Siddhar Mahiya, this is the state of Karnataka. Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal, this is the state of Assam. And Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, this is the state of Maharashtra. To be part of the committee will be headed by Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister N. Chandrababu Naidu. The state of Andhra Pradesh is over here. It will suggest measures to normalize the situation which has arisen due to demonetization. So we can see that all the prominent, the big states, those have been represented by their chief ministers in this committee. चलिए question number 53 देखते हैं. India has hosted the Golden Jubilee of which legal body of the UNO? इन options में से correct answer है option A, UNCITRAL, जिसे हम UNCITRAL भी कह सकते हैं. India hosted the Golden Jubilee, that is the 50th anniversary celebrations of UNCITRAL, that is United Nations Commission on International Trade Law in New Delhi. The opening address at this celebration was given by our President Pranab Mukherjee. This organization was established by the UN General Assembly in 1966 to promote progressive unification and harmonization of international trade law. It is the core legal body of the UN system in the field of international trade law. India is a founding member of UNCITRAL. आगे चलते हैं क्वेश्चन नंबर 54. द रिसेंटली इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इंक्रीमेंटल CRR बाय RBI इज हाउ मच? इसका आंसर है ऑप्शन सी 100%. द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड एन इंक्रीमेंटल कैश रिजर्व रेशियो ऑफ 100% फॉर अ फोर्टनाइट, दैट इज फॉर 15 डेज. टू एब्सॉर्ब द एक्सेस लिक्विडिटी इन द बैंकिंग सिस्टम फॉलोइंग द डीमोनेटाइजेशन. CRR is the proportion of deposits that banks have to keep as cash with the RBI or the central bank. आगे चलते हैं question number 55. We have to name the Indian who has won the gold medal at the AIBA Youth World Championships. In options में से correct answer है option A, Sachin Singh. Indian boxer Sachin Singh won the gold medal at the AIBA, that is the International Boxing Association Youth World Championship in the 49 kg weight class. In the summit clash held at St. Petersburg, Russia, Sachin defeated George Grenan of Cuba by 5-0 score. With this, he became the third Indian boxer ever to win a gold medal in the AIBA Youth World Championships. Others are Thokcham Nanao Singh, who won it in 2008, and Vikas Krishan, who won it in 2010. Question number 56 देखते हैं. The Supreme Court of India banned the sale of firecrackers in which Indian state? Supreme Court of India ने firecrackers की sale पर एक ban लगा दिया है, और वो किस state में है? Option C is the answer, that is Delhi NCR. The Supreme Court of India has banned the sale of firecrackers in Delhi NCR in an attempt to keep the rising pollution level of the capital and its surrounding areas under check. The order of the apex means that any sale, purchase or stocking of firecrackers in this area will be illegal. A ban on firecrackers also links it to the winter pollution. The Supreme Court ruling also sends a clear message that religious and wedding celebrations, जिनके लिए लोग firecrackers burn करते हैं, that takes a second place, उसका दर्जा दूसरा है, as compared to the basic fundamental right of an individual to breathe clean air under Article 21 of the Constitution of India. Although there is no restriction on bursting crackers, as this will be very difficult to implement and monitor. Supreme Court ne cracker bursting par koi restriction nahi lagai hai, kyunki usko implement karna, usko dhyan rakhna bahut mushkil hai. Lekin jahan tak sale, purchase aur crackers ki stocking ka sawal hai, usko illegal kar diya gaya hai, usko ban kar diya gaya hai. Question number 57. The National Milk Day is celebrated on the birth anniversary of which noted personality? The answer is option D, Dr. Verghese Kurien. The National Milk Day was observed on 26 November to mark the birth anniversary of Dr. Verghese Kurien, the father of the white revolution in India. This year it was his 95th birth anniversary, and it was the third edition of the day since it was established in the year 2016. The Gujarat Cooperative Milk Marketing Federation, which markets the Amul brand of milk and dairy products, printed 150 million milk pouches with the National Milk Day logo featuring Dr. Kurien's picture. Now, here are the important awards and honors which were given to Dr. Kurien. He had won the Ramon Magsaysay Award in 1963, World Food Prize in 1989, the Padma Shri in 1965, Padma Bhushan in 1966, and he was awarded the Padma Vibhushan in 1999. He also got the Economic Times Award for Corporate Excellence in the year 2001. क्वेश्चन नंबर 58 देखते हैं. व्हेन इज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे, जिसे हम संविधान दिवस भी कहते हैं, व्हेन इज इट सेलिब्रेटेड? इन ऑप्शंस में से करेक्ट आंसर है ऑप्शन सी, नवंबर 26. द संविधान दिवस और द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे ऑफ इंडिया इज ऑब्जर्व्ड ऑन 26 नवंबर टू स्प्रेड अवेयरनेस ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. इस दिन 1949 में कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया को अडॉप्ट किया गया था एंड इट केम इनटू फोर्स ऑन जनवरी 26, 1950, मार्किंग द बिगिनिंग ऑफ अ न्यू एरा इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ फ्री इंडिया. द यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट इज द नोडल मिनिस्ट्री फॉर द सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ दिस डे. दिस ईयर दिस इज द सेकेंड एडिशन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे. इस ओकेजन पर प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी ने दो बुक्स रिलीज की हैं. एक तो है मेकिंग ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन और दूसरी है न्यू वर्जन ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. इन अक्टूबर 2015 प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी हैड डिक्लेयर्ड 26 नवंबर एज द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डे एज पार्ट ऑफ ईयर लॉन्ग नेशन वाइड सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ 125th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर, हु वॉज द चेयरमैन ऑफ द ड्राफ्टिंग कमिटी of the Constituent Assembly which had drafted this Constitution of India. Question number 59 hai, which system will be introduced on Indian trains to prevent accidents? The answer is option D, Trinetra. Indian Railways apni railway system pe ye system dalega, that is Trinetra. Iska full form hai Terrain Imaging for Diesel Driven Infrared Enhanced Optical and Radar Assisted System. Iska aim hai train accidents kam karna. This is an advanced system made up of high resolution optical video camera, high sensitivity infrared video camera and a radar based terrain mapping system. These three components will act as three eyes and that is why it is called Trinetra. The requirement of this system gained more pace after 14 bogies of the Patna-bound Indore-Rajendranagar Express went off the tracks near Kanpur-Dehat on 20 November 2016. Ye ek bahut hi bura rail accident tha, jisme 146 se zyada passengers mare gaye the aur 200 log ghayal hue the. चलिए क्वेश्चन नंबर 60 देखते हैं. वी हैव टू नेम द फर्स्ट वुमेन डायरेक्टर ऑफ LBSNAA एंड द आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी, उपमा चौधरी. उपमा चौधरी वाज अपॉइंटेड एज द न्यू डायरेक्टर ऑफ लाल बहादुर शास्त्री नेशनल एकेडमी ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एट मसूरी. उपमा चौधरी विल बी द 23rd डायरेक्टर एंड द फर्स्ट वुमेन डायरेक्टर ऑफ दिस Institute. She will replace Rajiv Kapoor. She is a 1983 batch IAS officer of the Himachal cadre. Currently, she is posted as Additional Chief Secretary in Himachal Pradesh. LBSNAA. This is India's premier institution dedicated to training officers of the country's highest civil services. It was established in 1959 in Mussoorie, Uttarakhand, as the National Academy of Administration by merging the IAS Training School Delhi and IAS Staff College Shimla. Question number 61 dekhte hain. What is the theme of the International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women? And the answer is option B, Orange the World, Raise Funds to End Violence Against Women. द इंटरनेशनल डे फॉर एलिमिनेशन ऑफ वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन दैट इज IDEVAW. इट इज ऑब्जर्व एवरी ईयर अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड ऑन 25 November. द थीम फॉर दिस ईयर वॉज ऑरेंज द वर्ल्ड रेज फंड्स टू एंड वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन. ऑरेंज कलर इस दिन का थीम कलर है बिकॉज इट सिंबलाइजेज अ बेटर फ्यूचर टू वुमेन एंड गर्ल्स ऑल ओवर द ग्लोब विदाउट द परवेसिव ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेशन विच अफेक्ट्स 1 in 3 वुमेन एंड गर्ल्स ऑल ओवर द ग्लोब. द UN जनरल असेंबली हैड डेजिग्नेटेड दिस डे थ्रू अ रेजोल्यूशन पास्ड इन December 1999. क्वेश्चन नंबर 62 है, व्हाट इज इंडियाज रैंकिंग इन द 2016 ICT डेवलपमेंट इंडेक्स एंड द आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी 138. द इंडेक्स वाज रिलीज्ड एज पार्ट ऑफ द एनुअल मेजरिंग ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन सोसाइटी रिपोर्ट ऑफ द इंटरनेशनल टेलीकम्युनिकेशंस यूनियन. इन 2015 इंडिया का रैंक था 135. इस रैंकिंग की टॉप 5 कंट्रीज हैं साउथ कोरिया, आइसलैंड, डेनमार्क, स्विट्जरलैंड, यूके. फॉर इम्प्रूविंग दिस रैंकिंग इंडिया नीड्स टू इम्प्रूव द इंटरनेट एक्सेस टू द अनडिजर्व्ड टू रिड्यूस डिजिटल डिवाइड. देयर इज ऑल्सो अ नीड टू चेंज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द मिनिमम ब्रॉडबैंड स्पीड. द फेयर यूजेज पॉलिसी लेवल्स मस्ट बी रिलैक्स्ड विच आर अमंग द मोस्ट रिस्ट्रिक्टिव इन द वर्ल्ड. Efforts should also be taken to promote the use of mobile phones in rural areas. Besides, more efforts must be taken to increase the access of mobile phones to more women. Question number 63 hai, which is the 4th data satellite successfully launched by China? In options mein se correct answer hai option A, Tianlian I-04. The satellite was launched on board of Long March 3C carrier rocket from the Zhejiang Satellite Launch Center in southwest Sichuan province. Tianlian 1 and CTDRS-1 is a Chinese data tracking and relay communication satellite series. Functionally, it is similar to US tracking and data relay satellite system. China has launched its first data relay satellite, the Tianlian I-01, in April 2008. The second and the third relay satellite was launched in July 2011 and July 2012 respectively. Question number 64. Name the new US ambassador to UN. And in options, mein se correct answer hai option D, Nikki Haley. Nikki Haley becomes the first Indian American to be appointed to the cabinet level post in any US administration. She is also the first female appointment to a cabinet level post and overall 6th appointment of the president-elect Donald Trump-led administration. She became the first woman to serve as a governor of South Carolina in 2011. Currently, she holds the distinction of being the youngest current governor in the US. She is also the second Indian American after Bobby Jindal to serve as the governor of a state in the US. She is one among 6 Asia American governors of the US. Question number 65, dekhte hain, we have to name the newly appointed chairman of the NHAI. And the answer is option C, Yudhvir Singh Malik. The Union Government has appointed Yudhvir Singh Malik as the chairman of the National Highway Authority of India. He will succeed his predecessor, outgoing chairman Raghav Chandra, who has been moved as the secretary to the National Commission for Scheduled Tribes. Malik is a 1983 batch IAS officer of the Haryana cadre. Prior to this appointment, he was posted as Special Secretary in the Niti Aayog. Question number 66, dekhte hain, who has been honored with the International Press Freedom Award? The answer is option D, Malini Subramaniam. Indian journalist Malini Subramaniam was conferred with the 2016 International Press Freedom Award. She has been honored for her reporting from the Naxal-infested Bastar area and for the commitment to a free press. She is among the four journalists selected by the committee to protect journalists for this year's award. Others are Oscar Martinez from El Salvador, Ken Dunder from Turkey, and Abou Zeid from Egypt. The IPFA honors journalists or their publications around the world for showing courage in defending press freedom despite facing attacks, threats, or imprisonment. The award was established in 1991 and is administered by the Committee to Protect Journalists. This is an independent NGO based in New York, USA. Question number 67. Who will be the chief guest at the 14th Pravasi Bhartiya Divas, that is a day specially for the NRIs? The correct answer is option A, Antonio Costa. This is Antonio Costa. He is the Indian origin Prime Minister of Portugal. He will be the chief guest at the 14th Pravasi Bhartiya Divas convention. This convention is scheduled to be held from January 7 to 9, 2017 in Bengaluru, Karnataka. Mr. Costa will participate in the inaugural session of this convention on January 8 and he will also address the delegates. Besides, Suriname Vice President Michael Ashwin Satyendrik Adhin will be the special guest at the Youth Pravasi Bhartiya Divas to be held in Bengaluru on January 7, 2017. Question number 68, dekhte hain. Who is the newly elected president of FICCI? The answer is option D, Pankaj Patel. Pankaj Patel was elected the president of Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry for the year 2017. He will take over after incumbent Ambuja Neotia Group Chairman Harshvardhan Neotia completes his term in December 2016. At present, Pankaj Patel is the Chief Managing Director of Zydus Cadila. Let us see question number 69. Mangalam Palli Balamurli Krishna was associated with which art? In options may say, correct answer option B, Carnatic music. Legendary vocalist, playback singer and composer Mangalam Palli Balamurli Krishna passed away due to age-related geriatric problems in Chennai. He was 86. He was considered as doyen of classical music. During his long musical career, he has excelled as a prominent Carnatic vocalist, multi-instrumentalist and playback singer, composer and actor. The awards and honors conferred on him, Padma Vibhushan in 1991, Mahatma Gandhi Silver Medal from the UNESCO in 1995, France Chevalier of the Order des Arts et des Lettres. He is also a recipient of the Filmfare Awards and National Film Awards for Best Music Direction and Playback Singing. Okay, students, let us see question number 70. Which Indian golfer has won the Indonesia Open? The answer is option C, Gaganjit Bhullar. This is ace Indian golfer Gaganjit Bhullar who has won the Indonesia Open for the second time in his career. He won the title after closing with a 4-under-par 68. Earlier, he had also won this event in the year 2013. With this year's victory, he has sealed his 7th Asian Tour victory. It was his second title 2016 season with a 16-under-par 272 total at the Pondok Indah Golf Course in Jakarta. Is jeet ke saath, Bhullar is the 5th player after Thawon Whitcraft, Thailand, Frank Nobilo, New Zealand, Frankie Minoza, Philippines and Lu Shicheon, Chinese Taipei to win this event twice. Question number 71. Who has been awarded with the IMO Exceptional Bravery at Sea Award? In options may say correct answer hai option D, Radhika Menon. Captain Radhika Menon was awarded with the International Maritime Organization Award for Exceptional Bravery at Sea. She became the first woman in the world to receive the award. She was presented with this award for saving lives of 7 fishermen from sinking fishing boat in the Bay of Bengal. Question number 72 dekhte hain. We have to name the cities which will be connected by India's longest expressway. इन ऑप्शंस में से करेक्ट आंसर है ऑप्शन डी, आगरा एंड लखनऊ. हियर इज सम इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दिस एक्सप्रेसवे. द आगरा लखनऊ एक्सप्रेसवे इज अ 6 लेन ग्रीनफील्ड एक्सप्रेसवे हैविंग अ टोटल लेंथ ऑफ 302 किलोमीटर्स. इसकी जो डिजाइन स्पीड है दैट इज अप टू 120 किलोमीटर पर आवर. ये कहां से स्टार्ट होता है? आगरा से. और ये जिन टाउन से पास होता है दैट इज फिरोजाबाद, मैनपुरी, इटावा, औरैया, कन्नौज, हरदोई, उनाव, कानपुर टू रीच लखनऊ. इट पासेस थ्रू 4 नेशनल हाईवेज, 2 स्टेट हाईवेज एंड 5 रिवर्स दैट इज गंगा, यमुना, साय, इसान एंड कल्याणी. दिस एक्सप्रेस वे विल हेल्प कट डाउन द टाइम बिटवीन आगरा एंड लखनऊ टू जस्ट 3.5 hours फ्रॉम द करंट 7 hours. Moreover, it is expected to reduce the road travel time between Delhi and Lucknow to anywhere between 5 to 6 hours. The expressway has 2-kilometer dedicated stretch built for fighter jets to land and take off in times of war-like emergencies. The 6-lane expressway can also be expanded to 8-lane. Let us see question number 73. What is India's rank in the 2017 Climate Change Performance Index? The answer is option A, 20th. The CCPI is an instrument designed to enhance transparency in international climate politics. It is a list of countries doing most to combat the climate change. It aims to put social and political pressure on those countries which have up till now failed to take ambitious action on climate protection. The index evaluates and compares the climate protection performance of the 58 countries which are a member of this on the basis of standardized criteria. These 58 countries together are responsible for about 90% of global energy-related carbon dioxide emissions. Question number 74. We have to name the new super-Earth type exoplanet discovered by scientists. और इसका आंसर है ऑप्शन बी, GJ536b. साइंटिस्ट ने डिस्कवर किया है एक नया सुपर अर्थ टाइप का एक्सोप्लैनेट जिसका नाम उन्होंने रखा है GJ536b. इट इज ऑर्बिटिंग अ वेरी ब्राइट स्टार नियर टू आवर सन. व्हाट इज एन एक्सोप्लैनेट? इट इज अ प्लैनेट दैट डज नॉट ऑर्बिट द सन एंड इंस्टेड इट ऑर्बिट्स अ डिफरेंट स्टार, अ स्टेलर रेमनेंट और अ ब्राउन ड्वार्फ. It is also termed as an extrasolar planet. Super Earth is an extrasolar planet which are larger than the Earth. However, they have mass substantially below the solar system's giant planets, namely Neptune and Uranus. Question number 76. We have to name the recipient of the first World Sanskrit Award. In options mein se answer hai option C, Mahachakri Sirindhorn. थाईलैंड की राजकुमारी है ये महाचक्री सिरिंधोन, जिनको फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड संस्कृत अवार्ड दिया गया है फॉर हर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन फॉर प्रमोशन ऑफ द लैंग्वेज फॉर द ईयर 2015. इनके अलावा अमेरिकन लिंग्विस्ट एंड इंडोलॉजिस्ट प्रोफेसर जॉर्ज कार्डोना को भी ये अवार्ड दिया गया है फॉर द ईयर 2016. इन दोनों को ये अवार्ड वाइस प्रेसिडेंट हमीद अंसारी ने दिया है एट अ फंक्शन हेल्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली. शी इज अ नोटेड एजुकेटर एंड स्कॉलर ऑफ संस्कृत एंड पाली. दिस अवार्ड वॉज इंस्टीट्यूटेड बाय द इंडियन काउंसिल फॉर कल्चरल रिलेशंस. क्वेश्चन नंबर 76. वी हैव टू नेम द विनर ऑफ द 2016 दिल्ली हाफ मैराथन. इन ऑप्शंस में से करेक्ट आंसर है ऑप्शन बी, एलुइट किपचॉग. Kenya's Olympic marathon champion Eliud Kipchoge has won the men's race in Delhi half marathon. और women's title की winner है Ethiopia की Verknesh Degefa. Question number 77. We have to name the newly appointed executive chairman of the National Legal Services Authority. In options में से correct answer है option A, Jagdish Singh Kehar. The Union Government has appointed Jagdish Singh Kehar, a judge of the Supreme Court, as the new executive chairman of the National Legal Services Authority. He succeeds Anil R. Dave, who retired as judge of the Supreme Court after completing his tenure of over 6 years. The Nalsa provides free legal aid to the poor and weaker sections of the society. It has been constituted under the Legal Services Authorities Act 1987. Question 78 hai, who out of these is the winner of the 2016 Infosys Engineering and Computer Science Award? In options mein se correct answer hai option C, V. Kumaran. The Infosys Science Foundation has announced 6 winners of the Infosys Prize 2016 in 6 different categories of the award. They will be given with this award at the award ceremony, which is scheduled to be held in Bengaluru on 7 January 2017. Engineering and Computer Science ka winner hai V. Kumaran. Humanities mein winner hai Sunil Amrit. Life Sciences mein winner hai Gagandeep Kang. Mathematical Sciences mein winner hai Akshay Venkatesh. Physical Sciences mein winner hai Anil Bhardwaj. Social Sciences ki winner hai Kaivan Munshi. Infosys Prize is an annual award which is bestowed upon researchers, scientists, social scientists and engineers in India by the Infosys Science Foundation. Question number 79. As per the recently released 48th edition of the top 500 list of supercomputers, which is the world's fastest supercomputer? The answer is option A, Sunway Taihulite. Sunway Taihulite is built entirely using processors designed and made in China. It had made its first public appearance in 2016, June. It was developed by China's National Research Center of Parallel Computer Engineering and Technology. It can perform 93 quadrillion calculations per second, almost 3 times as fast as Tanhe 2. June 2016, Taihulite had dethroned the former fastest supercomputer, Tanhe 2, also a Chinese system, but built based on Intel chips. Prior to its introduction, Tanhe 2 had claimed top spot in top 500 list for the past 3 years. Taihulite is intended for use in research and engineering including climate, weather, life sciences, advanced manufacturing and data analytics. Let us see question number 80. We have to name the joint India-China military training exercise 2016. In options mein se correct answer hai option C, hand in hand. The 6th edition of India-China Joint Training Exercise Hand in Hand 2016 has started in Pune, Maharashtra. The aim of this bilateral military exercise is to share expertise in drills and practices while tackling insurgency and terrorism between Indian Army and People's Liberation Army of China. Thus, it seeks to promote healthy military two military relations between the two armies and developing joint strategies for conducting operations in a counter-terrorism environment. So, in dono armies ka main aim hai, aisi strategies develop karna jo terrorism ko counter kar sake. With this, the lesson comes to an end. Thank you for watching and do subscribe to our channel Success Series Education.